Now, let's talk about, I want to talk about bookings for just a little bit, because I think we have, I think we're stuck on a certain booking activity, or what we give away is what helps us to be successful in booking shows. And as I've been kind of training and watching people and talking people, I've really discovered, you know, long time ago when I was in high school, they, you know, would teach us in science that Pavlov dog theory. And, you know, that was the theory where they'd ring the bell and they would condition these dogs that when they'd hear the bell, they would go and eat the food. And so that's the same way in our jewelry shows. And so this is called Pavlov booking. And this is how you can do certain things at your shows that are going to be guaranteed to push a lady's hot button, to be able to guide her to what you're trying to do. And in this case, it's going to be having a show with you. Okay? So instead of just giving you a lot of try this, do this, I want to give you some how do you push the lady's hot buttons to get the results that you want. Okay? So it's Pavlov's booking. Are you ready? But you're not dogs. So there's six things I want to share with you. The first one is you are going to have to make an assumption that everybody's going to want to have a show. You know, and I know that you hate it when we talk about attitude and mindset, but you know what? Bottom line, you got to get the head right before you can get anything else right. And if you're driving to your shows and you're saying things to yourself like, she's probably not going to have anybody there. I don't even think she did it, got her pre-sales. You know, she didn't even act like she was there, very excited. You know, I mean, if you're doing that kind of stuff, you know what? You get exactly what you're expecting. But if you're driving there and you're going, you know what, this is going to be fun. I'm so excited. I've got those QR codes on my jewelry, and they're going to have so much fun looking at all that. I'm so excited. I just got that new piece, and I've learned how to show that three ways. I'm going to show that. You know what? These ladies are going to have so much fun. I know that everybody's going to want to have a show. This is going to be the best show I've ever had. You know what? You get what you think about. And I'm going to tell you, so much of what happens in this business is what happens in your brain when you're driving to that show. And that's what you've got to really guard yourself against. Now, why would I assume everyone wants to book? It's not because of me. I really, honest to goodness, there's a bunch of girls in this room that do a better show than I do. Now, I don't know if they're funnier than me, but I'm going to tell you, they do a lot better job of showing jewelry and all that stuff. I goof up. I drop stuff. I trip over things that aren't even on the floor. I mean, I do all kinds of stuff. But you know what? The thing is, I'm so confident that they're going to want to have a show, because you know what? I know there is no other company better than Premier that gives away more free stuff than we do. And I can't imagine why someone wouldn't want free stuff. You know? I don't want to pay if I can get it free. I also know that we've got, our hostess plan is great. Our product is awesome. If you haven't been and toured Premier Manufacturing, go do that. Do yourself a favor and go see how that jewelry is made. Honest to goodness, when I watch them set those stones and do all that stuff, I get reminded of the Lucille Ball episode in the candy factory, where it just is coming and they're just cramming it and stuffing it. That's how I would be at that manufacturing plant. I don't know how those girls do it, but I'm going to tell you, it'll give you a new appreciation of the great product that we have. We've got a great hostess plan. We've got a great product. You know what? This is fun and easy. And something I say throughout all my show is, this is so much fun. This is so easy. This is so much fun. I don't know about you, but I am having fun. This is so much fun. I am constantly saying that over and over. And I don't care if you're bubbly or if you're low-keyed, you can still say the words, because you're feeding, just like you feed yourself positive, you're going to be feeding them positive to what you want to have happen. And so the first thing is assume what? Everyone wants to have a show. Get your head in the game. If your head's not in the game, you're not having a game, okay? Second thing is, remember that no never means no. And this was hard for me. When I first got in Premier, if they said, no, thank you, I don't want to have a show, I really would take it personally. I go, oh, do they not like me? We always assume it's about us. I don't know why we do that. Did I do something wrong? Did I kind of set it different? I didn't show enough. I showed too much. Oh my gosh, I forgot to do this. You know what? My last shows that I've had, my last three shows, I booked 5 shows at each show. And you know what? I didn't even tell them the hostess plan. I got in the car and went, shoot, I forgot to tell them the hostess plan. And so it made me realize, you know what? The stuff I'm talking about is what makes people's hot button go to I'm doing what she's asking me to do. So no doesn't mean no. Here's what no means. No means I need more time. Did you know 80% of the people that come to your show are processing people? Processors don't make fast decisions. When you play a game, which you need to, because that's part one of your booking activity. You know your booking activity has part one and part two. Part one is where you get the people that are fun, friends, food, let's go. Part two is where you get the thinkers. And so you've got to understand, just because they don't play that game doesn't mean no means no. And you've got to train your head to go, you know what? She said no. No, she didn't. She said, I need more time. And in your head you go, she needs more time. I'll get her at part two. And you just got to run that through your head over and over. She needs more time. I'll get her at part two. She needs more time. I'll get her at part two. So that way you don't look any different. You don't act any different. Your facial expression still looks happy. No could mean I don't understand what you are saying. Okay? And I think we get ourselves into that. You know, we have said this hostess plan over and over and over and over and over. And we just assume that everybody that hears it absorbs it. And you know what? I got to tell you, it was a long time before I really remembered what the hostess plan really was about. And you've got to understand, these people are listening to you for the first time. So their no may be, I don't know what you are saying. And so my answer is no. Have you ever had that happen? Somebody called you on the phone. They wanted you to do something. They started talking real fast, blah, 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 blah. And they said, okay, what do you think? Can you do it? And you were like, like she lost me at hello. I mean, I don't even know what she's saying. And so you go, well, I don't think so. It's not that you didn't want to do it. It's because you didn't understand. And ladies are not going to get themselves involved in something that they don't have a clear idea of what's expected of them. So no could mean I don't understand. No also could mean you have not answered what's in it for me. So no could mean, well, what's in it for me if I get my friends together? And see, I think your show from start to finish ought to be a process of answering that question, what's in it for me? Okay, so no means what? I need more time. No could also mean? No could also mean? Yeah, what's in it for me? They don't have a clear idea of what's in it for me, so they're not going to spend their time doing it. Guys, here's the deal. Everybody's busy. Okay, you know, this whole thing of, well, I'm so busy. Well, I'm so busy. Everybody's busy. But you know what? People still keep getting things done. Okay, so busy people are good. And there's not one person I've met that goes, I'm not busy at all. I just sit around my house all day long. And I now don't watch soap operas. I just watch things that I've, you know, recorded or taped or whatever you call it. And I eat bonbons. Nobody's ever said that to me. Everybody's busy. Even people I don't think are busy tell me they're busy. Those are called teacup saucer people. They have one brownie on their plate and they are busy. And I'm a platter. I'm like a rolling buffet, you know. And I'm just like going, seriously? Okay, awesome. Okay. No can also mean not right now. You know, they say no, but they're saying in their head, not right now because we're remodeling our kitchen. Or they say no out loud to you, but in their head they're going, my daughter's getting married in a month and I just can't do anything else. Or no outside to you may be in their head, my kids are starting college and I'm trying to get them all ready and I'm trying to get them all off to school and I just can't do this right now. So no could mean not right now. And you know what surprises me? I think then not right now means 6 months later. But I'm amazed at how many not right nows mean like, okay, well, I could do it in September. I'm like, well, okay, awesome. on that. So the point is, don't take it personally. When you start letting this get personally and into your head, then you know what it does? It makes you insecure. And when you become insecure, then you won't put yourself out there. And when you won't do that, it's flatlining for you. And that's not a good thing, is it? That means your business is dead. I think that, Stacy, is it flatlining, dead? Yes, she's a nurse. She knows lots of things like that. If you fall and crack your head, talk to Stacy, okay? Run away from me. I don't do body goop at all, okay? But I'll make you a dinner, okay? I can cook a mean pot roast in the crock pot. Okay, so our first thing we've got to understand is what? Assume. Okay, I want you to give me some gusto here. Number two, no. Okay, and you wrote all that stuff down on what it really means. Okay, you got to get this in your head. Now, number three, visual aids are important. 87% of the people that attend your shows are visual learners. 87%. So that means if you have 10 people at a show, 8 and a pregnant woman are visual learners, okay? That, I mean, you think about it though, but what do we do? What do we tend to do at our shows? Talk and make assumptions. I think we make assumptions that they understand, we make assumptions that they get it, and we just keep talking and keep talking. Well, you know what I learned a long time ago? The person who talks the most always loses. Always. I don't want to be the person that's talking the most. Showing visuals is way more important than what you're saying to people. Here's what you're really doing. Your whole show is creating a Kodak picture for them of what a show would be like for them and how much they're going to get. That's what I'm doing. I'm just trying to give them snapshots. So for example, I'm going to tell you some of my visuals that I use and show you how I make a picture so that at the time that I'm going to do booking, they've got so many pictures flashing through their heads of this is a lot of stuff. Oh my gosh, this is fun. Oh my gosh, this is easy. That's why they say yes to me. So first thing I have is a clipboard that's fun. Now, if you're foo-foo impaired, this is so easy. This is man's best friend, duct tape. Okay? So it's a clipboard with duct tape strips on it. And then to cover the ugly silver part, this is just little ribbons tied in knots all the way across. I know you can tie in knots because if you have anything with shoelaces, they're probably always in knots. Okay? So I know you can do that. So I give them something kind of fun. Attached to it are their two $50 gift cards. And these are recyclable, okay? This is just a prop for me. I'm not buying a jillion of these. I'm just using it. And also on here is my Diva Hostess Club. And what happens is people go, what do you give your hostess? Do you give her a gift? Yes, this is her gift. She gets the hostess plan and this. And this says that for the whole year, she can buy from me at 20% off. And on the week of her birthday or anniversary, she can get something for 50% off. Now, I always let her read this to the group for two reasons. One, it's too little and I can't see it. The second reason is when she reads it for the first time like this. This card entitles you to receive 20% discount on any... I get 20% discount. Oh my gosh. And all the friends are like this. Wow, that's awesome. I know. I go, keep reading. And I get 50% off. I get 50%. They are so cute when they are reading it to their friends and their friends are going back and forth. When I read it, do you know what happens? I go into robot mode. I've seen it, I've read it, and I just, okay, that's not good. So that's what she does. So it starts out kind of like this. Hey, I'm so excited y'all are here. This is going to be so much fun tonight. I'm so excited that Dee is having me over, and I want to just give this to Dee right now. This is her clipboard to hang on to tonight because everything Dee is getting is 50% off or free. Let's give it up for Dee for half price and free. That's right. And you know what, Dee? You've also got attached something really special. You know what? If I told you right now that you could have two $50 Steinmark gift cards, would you be pumped? Yeah. Well, guess what? Dee is getting two $50 gift cards to my very favorite store, Premier Designs Jewelry. Can you believe this? Let's give it up for Dee again for $50 gift cards and free and half price. Way to go, Dee. And Dee, also, just because you are a very special friend to me and in letting me come to your house to meet your friends, I have a special, you're part of a club now, and I want you to read this to them. And she reads that to them. Now, do you see, I've already created one picture for them of everything's free, everything's half price. Two $50 gift cards. Is that pretty much all they need to know? Do they need me to read them a bunch of stuff sideways with enthusiasm? No, I've already clicked a picture in their mind. Dee's a hostess. She gets half price and free because I've said it over. Give it up for Dee. Half price and free. Ooh, that rhymes. That's good. Okay. They don't all work that way. Okay. So that's the very first visual picture I'm going to create for them. Okay. Is using that clipboard. The second picture is, you know what? A lot of people get it with that. But then you got people from the show me state. They're the people that go, okay, I hear what you're saying. I know Dee's getting it half price and free. I know she's getting those two gift cards, but prove it. So if that's not good enough, you know what? Let me just tell you what my last four hostesses got in jewelry. And then I have my last four home shows. And I just start reading. Her show total was $554. My profit was $188. She got $216.20 in free jewelry. And I just go right down the list. Now, I don't change this every four shows, okay? I keep it for a few months, and then we change it again. I don't care if there's a $200 show on here, because you know what? Those are more impressive than the big shows are, because they hear you go, she had a $200 show, I made $100, and she got $83 in free jewelry. And they'll go, she got $83 and her show was just $200? Like, that's a big deal to them. So I'm not trying to finagle this so they're all big. I want, you know, and I don't care if they were all 300 and under. That's still a good deal in their head. So they've heard. 50%, half price, $50 gift cards. They've seen now, here's what four real people actually got. And then I'll say, if that's not enough, let me just show you what my average hostess gets free. And I will either hold up a tray of jewelry, or I'll show them on the mannequin, or I'll show them on me, or I'll show them on the hostess, whatever way is good for you. So now, do I need to say a whole lot more about what our hostesses get? Think about it. They know it's 50%. They know it's, you know, free. They know there's two gift cards in there somehow. I don't need to get them all bogged down with words and words. And you get this $50 card when you have $100 in pre-sales and blah, 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 blah. You don't change your original date. The more you say, the more confused they are. And the more words that you put in there, especially with numbers, they clog them all up and move them all over the place, okay? And that's not what. And then when it comes to my hostess plan, oh, I didn't bring them. Oh, well. You know, I have my posters, my home show posters, hooked together with rings, okay, so that I can drop them. I don't even read the posters. I go, guys, you are not going to believe this. Look how much jewelry you are getting just for letting me come over and have some fun with your friends. Drop the posters, bam, 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 and all their head goes is, oh, my gosh, did you see how much stuff was on that poster? See, it's the picture you're creating. So by the time I get to my booking activity, they have thought 50% and free. $50 gift cards. Man, those four people got a lot of jewelry. Wow, there was a lot of jewelry in that tray she showed. Oh my gosh, those posters just kept going forever. This is a good deal. Okay, do you understand that? And I think that's where we're getting it wrong. I think we're trying to explain so much so that no stone is unturned that they're getting confused. And because they're confused, they're not hearing what's in it for them, or they're not understanding what's expected of them. And so you know what they're going to say? No. But what does no mean? Not right now. Okay. Still thinking. You are a processor. Okay. So those are all of my visuals that I use. Okay. Everybody write all that down so you kind of got that. Now, booking activity. Okay. So number one was assume everybody would book. Number two is? No doesn't mean no. Come on. Get with me. Come on. Number three are visual aids. Number four, booking activity part one and part two. Oh, it's time for spontaneous dancing. Woo! Yeah. That was fun. All right. Now I got you back going again. Okay. Booking activity part one and part two. What is that? Okay. Part one is your activity. Maybe it's your bling board. I knew it was bling and I knew it was something. I couldn't remember if it was bingo or what. Okay, maybe it's your bling board. Maybe that's your booking activity. Awesome. If that is working for Elizabeth and they're rolling those dice and they are having fun and they are doing it, man, I go, go, Elizabeth, go. But you know what? You've got to have something that's going to be fun for you. A booking activity only works if you like it. If you don't like it, it's not going to work. And that's why you can see somebody do something and you go, I tried that and I'm telling you, I couldn't get them to get off the chair or do anything. But then they do it and it's just magnificent. It's because they're excited. Get something that's fun for you, that you can't wait to pull it out and show them. Now I'll show you what I use, okay? But like I said, it works for me because I like it. So that's the only reason it works. If you don't like it, it probably won't work for you. Okay? So here's what I have for my booking activity. I have the little leather and cross bracelets. I have the brown and gold, and I have the black and silver. They come from Premier Incentives. They're under a dollar, okay, each. And then I have a basket of pashminas. Now, the reason I have these right now is I have a ton of that, and that's why I'm using it. And when I run out of all that, then I'm going to use whatever else is in my closet that I have a bunch of, okay? You can use retired jewelry. If you have that, you can do whatever you want. But here's the key to whatever your prize is sell the sizzle. Paint a picture of them in that thing, whatever it is. And I'm going to tell you how I do that. I'll say, now, ladies, we're gonna play a little game right now, and we are going to use some scratch-offs. How many of you like scratch-offs? Anybody? I know I do, man. When McDonald's has that Monopoly scratch-off, I can't wait to go through the line. I've never even won a Coke or anything. But you know what? I just think it's fun to scratch it off. Take the chance. Am I going to win? You know, am I going to win some fries? Yes! My veins love me. All right. Okay. So what I'm going to do first is I just want to pass this around, and I want every one of you to take one of your scratch-offs. And I let them take their card. Now, just don't scratch it off yet, okay? Because let me tell you, every one of you is going to get to win something. How does that make you feel? Have any of you ever said, I've never won anything in my whole life? They all raise their hand. I go, well, not tonight, because here's what's going to happen. You might scratch this off, and yours might say B. B means bracelet, and you win this awesome bracelet. Can you see yourself with this in brown and gold or black and silver? You're just wearing it, and you're at the PTA meeting, and someone goes, where did you get that bracelet? I won it. I never win anything, but I won this. I said, this could be yours if you scratch off and you have the B. Now, you could scratch yours off and it could say P, and that means pashmina. Does anybody know what a pashmina is? And they give me the craziest answers. This is what I typically go, a shawl? I go, yes. Back in the days when we were in covered wagons, we wore shawls or pashminas. No, that's not it. Someone will go, is it a cloak? Go, no, Harry Potter wore an invisible cloak, and a pashmina is not a cloak. I said, well, let me just show you what a pashmina is. And I'll pull my pashmina out, and I say, picture this. You're at a restaurant. You're at your table. You're in the vent. Satan that's blowing on you. And you go, wait, I have a pashmina. You pull it out of your purse, you wrap it around. The restaurant stops. People go, look at that fashionista with a pashmina. That's you. Never again are you chilly in a restaurant or a theater, ever again. And they're all just, and this is how they look at me. This is how you sell the sizzle. You pretend you are telling a story to a four-year-old, okay? And they just go like this. I said, but some of you on your card, you may not have a B, you may not have a P. You may have let's party. Let's party means you win the bracelet, you win the pashmina, and you win me. Coming to your house, your office, Starbucks, your house, my house, wherever it is fun, wherever it is easy, wherever it makes you go, wow, I got a lot of jewelry fun and I don't even think I did a thing. I said, it's so easy now for you to do this because our website is out there. You can send that catalog all over the country to all your friends and family that owe you something. You know what? We have all of our invitations now are through texting, are through emails. You don't have to worry about that at all. It is so easy to get your girlfriends together. Any place, any time, whatever is easy for you, that's what I want to do for you. So are you ready? Okay, if you want to play the game and you want to see if you win a bracelet, a pashmina, or a let's party, which me, the pashmina and the bracelet, on the count of three, you're going to hold your card up and we'll scratch that card off and we will see what you win. Ready? Everybody got your card? One, two, three. And I hold it up, and the second I hold it up, literally, they all hold their arms up. And I say to myself, they don't get it because everyone is playing. They do get it because they all know they're going to be able to take a chance to get a bracelet or a pashmina or me. And here's a common question. Oh, I got a bracelet. I wanted let's party. I go, honey, we can always upgrade. Okay, we love to upgrade. Then, okay, they go through and they scratch off and they tell me what they've won. And then I say this. Listen, if you girls will just hang with me for just a second, I want to get your prizes to you. And I'm going to let the rest of you go to the table and go find all those QR codes with your phones and figure out all the combinations that I didn't even show you tonight. And then the girls that have stayed behind, because I'm going to give them, they stay because they want their gifts. They fill out their card and I get all of that information with them, okay? And then I cut them loose to go over there and play in the jewelry as well. So that's kind of how I work my booking activity. Now, that's part one. You're going, okay, good. What's part two? Here's part two. This is good. Okay, at the beginning of my show, I have a very expensive Ziploc gallon baggie. I have a box of them. My current baggie I've used for 6 months, so it is now an antique. And so I have in my Ziploc baggie all my order forms and all of my pens. And so at the beginning of the show, I'll say something like this, ladies, you are going to get to touch an antique Ziploc baggie in just a minute. No one up to this day has torn the zipper off. Don't let it be you. And they're like this. And I go, so I want to pass this Ziploc around and I want you to get that pen out of there and get that order form out of there, okay? Pass that baggie around. And they pass it all around. Okay, then I said, now here's what we're going to do. This is for a ticket. I want you to fill the top part of your order form out. And as soon as you fill it out and you have written legibly so your third grade teacher is proud of you, then you just look at me and I'm going to give you a ticket for the drawing at the end. And they don't do anything. They sit there and stare at me just like you do. And then you go like this. It's called the nod. And you go, go on. Go on. And they go like this. So I want y'all to just practice that with me. It's the nod and go on. Okay, so ready? Here we go. Go on. Perfect. That's it. That's all you got to do. And y'all, I am not joking you. As sure as I'm standing here, you will do that. And in your head, you're going to go, oh my gosh, this is exactly what she said would happen is happening. I mean, this cannot be any more simple. Okay. So that's the nod. Go on. Okay, good. And then I give them their tickets for filling it out or Diva Dollars or whatever you want to do. Then I'll say, now listen, I'm going to show you a bunch of jewelry tonight. And I'm going to pass it around. You're going to get to touch it. You're going to feel it. Don't bite it. Okay, that's weird. But I want you to write down things as you see them that you like. And this is going to be your scribble sheet, your wish list right here. At the end, if there's anything on here that you've changed your mind on, we're just going to draw a line through it. Okay, and don't worry, it doesn't matter if it's messy because I'm seeing it and you're seeing it. Our company doesn't even see this. Now, as I'm passing around jewelry, I've constantly got to remind them to write stuff down because they're looking at it, they're looking with their friend, and so I've got to say, did anybody like this? And three girls will go, I did. Did you write on your paper? Oh no, I forgot. Okay, write it. Go on. Write it. So I'm constantly, throughout that time, I'm reminding them to write it down, okay? Because they get excited and forget. Now, here's part two. We've already done our little activity. They've gone to the table to shop, and they're bringing me their order forms. Here's part two. Are you ready? This is good. This is rich. This is Godiva at its finest. Okay? What is it, new people? Godiva. You're good. Go on. You can write that down. You can. Come on. You can do it. Okay. You didn't do it. Oh, now you are. Okay, good. Okay, so here's part two. The first girl brings her order form to me. I see that there's three things that are crossed out. And I might say something like this. Allison, I love what you picked out. These are some of the greatest pieces. These are going to look good on you. Oh, you know what? With those three pieces you crossed off, you're not going to believe this, but with about a $300 show, you could get those pieces free. Now, we can wait, and you mean you can kind of spread it out all year long, or we could get your girlfriends together, and we could get those pieces free. I mean, literally in the next 2 weeks, the next month. What do you think about that? She goes, really? And I go, yeah. And she says, nothing. Okay, and that's when we goof up, when they don't give us any kind of response. And here's your phrase. Well, let me ask you this, Allison. Write that down. Go on. I'm telling you, really do. Write this down. Well, let me ask you this, Allison. If you were to ever have a show anytime ever in your life, when would that be? What month? Well, probably December. Great. Well, if you were going to have a show in December, would it be a weekday or a weekend? Allison, just answer me.
Weekday.
Would that be like maybe a Tuesday or a Thursday?
Thursday?
A Thursday. Well, and then you flip over to December and you go, you know what, Allison? I have Thursday, December 7th. That's my only Thursday in December. What do you think about that? She'll take it. And that's how you do part two, because that gets the process, people. If you are just doing part one, you are missing over half of the people that are there. If you will do part two and do it just like that, Allison, if you were going to ever have a show ever in your life, what month would you choose? See, she thinks she has full control. I choose the month of bam. I don't care what month she says. Well, if you were going to have a show in December, then would it be on a weekday or a weekend? Weekend. Now, if you don't do weekends, then don't offer weekends, okay? Or I know some girls that they just do one Saturday a month, and that's their only weekend they offer, okay? So you got to figure that out for yourself. But see, that's what you're offering. You're always offering in twos. You do a weekday, great, Tuesday or Thursday. Oh, I do a Thursday. Wow, you know what? I have this date and this Thursday in December. Which one of those is best for you? And you will get them on the books every single time. But a lot of times, you know what they do? You know, if you were ever, Karen, if you were going to ever, ever, ever in your whole life have a show for premiere, when would it be? September. I'm like, well, I'm in September. Well, would you do it at the end of September or the middle of September? I'd probably do it at the end of September. Well, would you do it on a weekday or weekend? I mean, and I can get her in September just because She feels like she has had time to process this whole thing, and that's how you get them in the calendar. Does that make sense to you? Can you do that? Oh, yes, you can. Oh, yes, you can. So, and that's how you secure that date. I'm going to tell you, if they get out without putting a date down, you're probably going to have a hard time chasing them down. You're going to get busy. They're going to be busy. And, I mean, you're going to do the phone tag thing. I'm not going to say you won't ever catch up with them, but it's going to be a challenge for you. And that's why when you can do it like that, and if you've got them crossing off things on their list, and you can use that as a tool of going, we can get this stuff now. Why should we wait? You can get it free. Free is very appealing to people, okay? So, booking activity part one into part two. Do y'all do that?
Yes.
Okay, anything I've said so far that you thought in your head, I could do better at that. Okay, raise your hand. Three people, tell me once one thing you could do, you could add that you haven't done or you could do better at. One, two, three, one hand, go. Okay, excellent. Who else? Give me another. Karen.
Making sure that they fill out their information at the very beginning with their, you know, go on.
Okay, great. One more.
Locking the date down.
Good. Okay, good little snippets. Now, the next thing is you got to work smart. Guys, I think a lot of you work hard, okay? I'm not going to question the hard of your work, but what I might question is it smart? Because that's two different things. You know what? I've learned in Premier that I know how to work smart and play hard. And I like that combination a lot better, okay? So let me tell you some work smart things. Work smart would be, remember that our message has not changed in Premier. Our purpose, our philosophy, man, we are sticking with that. But you know what needs to change? Methods. Okay, you've got to say to yourself, my methods need to change on some things. And that means for those of you that social media has just gone, whew, and you are just like thinking, my hair is on fire. I can't even figure out what they're talking about. You have got to get some of this down. Do you have to be a super, you know, guru in it? No, but you've got to get enough down that you are sending those. See, now these girls that booked at my show, when I get home, they're sent a red stamp of a save the date that says, here's your save the date, go on and text this to your friends tonight or in the morning. Bam, they're in the loop. And so you've got to be able that you're doing smart things like that. And then that very next day, bam, here's the invitation that you can text or email out. Here's how to get on my website so that you can get on there and pick an invitation if you want to go that route. I mean, literally, so within 48 hours, they've gotten two things from you, a save the date and an invitation that they can send out to their hostesses, or your hostess, so she can send to her friends. You see, if you don't get them in the loop, if you let a week go by, guys, they're just caught up in their life. They forgot they even met you, and that's where you've got to stay in their phone. I've got it's a wooden cutout that says bling, and I have rings on every finger, and I'm going, holding it, and I send that to them so they can remember what I look like. You know, I'm excited to meet your friends, and here's the picture that comes up of me holding this sign going, you know, but that's my personality, okay? Some of you are very glamorous, and so maybe you should be glamorous pictures, but if they got a glamorous picture from me, I think they'd probably fall over. They wouldn't even recognize me. They wouldn't even know what to think about me. Okay, so we're going to work smart. We're going to learn how to use some of the social media tools that are going to be effective. You know, like I love what Carla McCain shared a few months back. You know, she worked smart by changing some verbiage. Guys, book a show is old school. If you're using that term other than with a premier jewelry lady, you are already, they have turned you off. You know what? Style session is almost out. You know what's in? Private party. I'm booking private parties of 8. I'm booking private parties of 4. I'm booking a private party of 4, and your first 4 guests that RSVP get a $20 gift card to spend that night. Private party. I mean, I'm telling you, you got to get your lingo up where people are going, wow, she's really got it. You know, I love the way this started. Carla was donating jewelry, I think this is right, to a silent auction. How many of y'all have ever done that? Donated an ensemble of jewelry. And Carla was telling me, she said, you know what? I do it a lot, and I just really haven't gotten a lot of mileage from that. So she said, I decided to donate to the silent auction a private party of eight. And what was the bid for that? You remember, 200? Okay, it went for $150 on a silent auction. And so she did a private party of eight. Carla bought the refreshments, had the refreshments. She did everything. The lady got to show up with eight of her friends. And I think the lady even said, can I bring 10? You know, she upped it. Yeah, and she's still gotten bookings from that. You know, one of my other girls did a vendor event, and she got 40 people that registered for the drawing of a private party for four, and each four of those people got a $20 gift card. And you know what she did? As they all put those names and all their information in the fishbowl, she called them all, and everybody won. So she called the first one, Ariana. Hey, this is Elizabeth Draper. I met you at the bridal fair, and I just want you to know you won. You won the private party. Then you called the next one, Carla, this is Elizabeth Draper. I met you at the bridal fair. You're not going to believe this. You won the private party. And you know what they say? I've never won anything. This is so exciting. Okay, guys, I promise you, but see, you've got to be smart in how you're handling things. You cannot just go, well, I'm not changing. It worked for me then. It's going to work for me now. You got to get work smart, work smart. You know, you've got to also learn to lead your conversations. Get conversations back on jewelry. Someone comes in late. They say, I'm sorry I was late. My sister called. She's coming in from Arizona. And I couldn't get off the phone with her. And so you know what? You get her over there when she's shopping with the jewelry and you go, Eris, did you say your sister was coming in town from Arizona? Yes. When? In 3 weeks. Oh my gosh, Eris, that would be a great time for you to get your girlfriends together and let me show the jewelry. They can meet your sister and your sister can meet your friends. Now, did Eris say she was going to do that? But I planted the seed. I'm leading conversations and planting the seed. You know, do you have such and such? They're looking at your table. They're looking in the catalog. Do you have such and such piece? Oh, I'm so sorry. I don't have that piece. But you know what? I can borrow it and bring it when you have your girlfriends over. Did she say she was going to do that? No. I'm leading conversations. That's working smart. Do you know what else works that's smart? Is learning to do customer care calls. And if you don't know what I'm talking about, go on the Draper website, go under the video training, and find Elizabeth Draper customer care calls. It's a 20-minute training on talking how to keep your customers in the loop and build relationships. People continue to have shows that have a relationship with you. If it's love them and leave them, you are going to be beating the bushes the rest of your life in Premiere. And you know what? It is not fun to hide behind a person's bush, like jump out, you know, like grab them. Okay, that's a joke. Okay, but maybe y'all didn't like that. Okay, awesome. You've also got to market yourself. You know, you've got to be creative in how you market yourself. You know, I've told this story several times, but I'll tell it in case you're new or you forgot it. You know, I did a show in a very wealthy part of town. These people have stupid money, and they don't even know what to do with it. And so everybody that came in was announced like they were coming into a castle, you know, at some debutante party or something. And so it's like, it was kind of like they didn't have a trumpet, but I just do the trumpet for fun. But the rest of it is true. They'd come in the door and go, this is such and such, and she is the only living heir to the Rolex Foundation. And everybody would like the golf clap. And I'm setting my jury up going, this is so and so. She makes Western saddles. She's made all the saddles for all the Western movies, like Lonesome Dove. Did you see that? She made all the saddles for that. And I'm just like going. I grew up in a lot of this kind of stuff at school. I went to a very ritzy school, even though my parents lived on the very edge of the school district. So I grew up with all this junk, you know, but that's why it kind of grosses me out. But anyway. So then she says, and now I'd like to introduce to you Elizabeth Draper. She's going to be showing our travel line of jewelry. I'm going. I'm thinking, okay, great. This is not going to work for me. I got to revamp. I got to think. Come on. Market yourself. You're smart. You can do this. Well, in the meantime, I've had one lady dump 8 watches in front of me. And she said, I'd like all these, darling. I can't stay for your presentation. I'm so sorry. But I want all these. Oh, well, you qualify for our purchase, $75, and you can get any item at $50 or less for $10. And she goes, darling, I'll just pay full price for them. It was the Rolex lady. And I'm thinking, what is she going to do with these? She's just going to, like, throw them to the workers at Rolex. Like, here, peasant that works for me, have a Premier watch instead of a Rolex watch. What I mean, I'm thinking... So hers was like $800, just her order. And she, darling, she wanted it all at full price. I'm like, fabulous, take it all. So in my head, I'm thinking, okay, this purchase $75 and get $50 for 10 probably is not gonna fly here. And I'm thinking my activity of big money, little money, probably is not gonna be going over too well either. And I'm thinking, bracelet, pashmina, let's party is probably gonna fall, okay, on deaf ears. Market yourself. What are you gonna do? And that's when I said, ladies, how many of you have something that is just really important to you? An organization, I mean, something that you love to be a part of and raise money for. Is there anybody here like that? I said, yes, I love dogs. I go, well, that is wonderful. I have 2 dogs. I'm trying to relate. And she said, and I'd like to do something for the Humane Society because, we really believe in rescuing dogs. I go, well, fabulous. Let's do something. Long story, 4 fundraisers were booked. But you know what? Those people didn't really help me a whole lot, but they contacted me with lots of other normal people that shop at Target, you know, Home Goods, you know, all of those great stores, Kirkland's, Hobby Lobby, you know, all those great places. So that's the whole point of marketing yourself. You've got to be on your toes. You don't know where you're going to be. You don't know what you're going to fall into. You've got to have your terminology down. Oh, I do private showings. You know, oh, yes. Oh, did you know you could win a private party for 4? I mean, those kind of things. Doesn't that sound, you know, ooh, foo-foo, fa-fa? Doesn't that sound good? I think you should try it. You know, so that's important, is learn to market yourself. And you got to think ahead to be able to do that. Now, you know what? This is not, I've decided that this is not a busy for the faint of heart. Because you know what? You've constantly got to be thinking. And you've got to go, you know, am I still doing stuff in the dinosaur era? Am I still using the Stone Age words? Or have I kind of gotten into 2014 and am I kind of like working with that? You know, am I still thinking that everybody's going to handwrite an invitation and mail it out to their friends? I don't think so. Would I love that? Yes, because I love getting notes. I love writing notes. But you know what? I've got to understand what I'm dealing with, and I've got to embrace that. And I want to really encourage you to do that. And I think if you will take some of the things that we've talked about tonight and you'll apply them to your business, you're going to see the bookings that you want to have. Because see, remember, it's all back about those Pavlo dogs. They'd ring the bell and the dogs would run. They'd ring the bell and the dogs would do this. And that's the same thing. When you apply the principles of booking, when you do those things, you're going to see those ladies run and they're going to have shows with you. And that's what you want, right? Now, can you do that? Oh, this is very exciting to me. I have trained my heart out and this is what I get. Can you do that? I think it's time for a spontaneous dance. Let's see.